हाय हेलो नमस्ते वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू बायो क्लासेस. आई थिंक ऑलरेडी फ्रॉम द बॉटनी साइड सो रिप्रोडक्शन ऑर्गेनिज्म देन जेनेटिक्स चैप्टर देन मॉलिक्यूलर वेज ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस देन सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन फ्लोरिंग प्लांट्स फोर चैप्टर्स हैव बीन कंप्लीटेड. फ्रॉम जुआलॉजी साइड आई थिंक फाइव चैप्टर्स हैव बीन कंप्लीटेड राइट इंक्लूडिंग वन फर्स्ट फ्यू चैप्टर ऑल्सो. सो एनी हाउ सो comparing to our actual CET date, that means examination date, still we are having a few days, just we are left with only few days, but number of chapters are more. Still we need to complete few chapters in second PU and at where we need to start first PU syllabus. So the problem irodrinda, so starting on the clarification code bittu nimge yen clarification andre namge number of days kadimi idave preparation ge kadimi ide. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅಷ್ಟು ಡೇಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಥೆರಾಟಿಕಲ್ ವೈಸ್ ಹೋದರೆ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ಗಳು ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಅವರ್ ಥೆರಾಟಿಕಲ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ಲೈನ್ ಟೈಮ್, ನೀವು ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿದ್ದ ನಾವು ಥಿಯರಿ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ, ಸೊ ಅದೇ ಥಿಯರಿ ವೇದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ಗಳು ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಸೊ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಮೇನ್ ಗ್ಲಿಂಪ್ಸಸ್ ಅಂತ ಏನಿರ್ತವೆ, ಸೊ ಮೇಜರ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸಿ ಇ ಟಿ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವ್ಯೂ, ಸೊ ಮೇಜರ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಏನಿರ್ತವೆ ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಫೋಕಸ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ ರೈಟ್. ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಡಿಲೇ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಜಂಪ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಅವರ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪಿ ಯು, ಬಯೋಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್. ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸಸ್ yes. So from biotechnology we are having two chapters, principal process first chapter, second one application chapter we are having. And one more thing keep in your mind, so this biotechnology chapter, it is majorly depending on the genetic material DNA, and molecular basis of inheritance also majorly depending on the DNA, but there we will observe the DNA related processes aspects, but here we will come to know the DNA related applications. That means after the modification of that DNA or genetic material, so what are the possibilities that we can get? So those things we can observe in a biotechnology principle and process chapter, right? The name itself suggests biotechnology means it is a combination of two terms. It is a combination of two terms, biology and technology. That means we are using the microorganisms, or we are using even larger organisms, or we are using the cell or cell enzymes, whatever it is. That means we are using the life, and that life is modified in the form of techniques. So by applying the techniques we are changing the life, and after changing the life something we have to get. That means one product we need to get, one service we need to get. That means here from biotechnology either we can get a product or service. So two possibilities are there. So product means, suppose if you want to say the biotechnological products, enzymes we can get, organic acids we can get, antibiotics we can get, then different kinds of even hormones we can get, different kinds of bioactive molecules we can get. So in microbial, microbes in human welfare chapter we know bioactive compounds. So those compounds we can get. Curd we can get, alcohol, bread, fermented products, all those are coming under products from the biotechnology. Suppose if we consider service, so service means, so one best thing we are having, STP, already we know, what is that STP? Sewage treatment plant. In case of the treatment of sewage, we are using a microorganism. That means using of any organism for our well-being is called as biotechnology. For our well-being, if you are using microorganism or any organism it is, then we will call it as biotechnology. And here, in the biotechnology, usually we are having two forms, two types of biotechnology. The first one is traditional biotechnology. Traditional biotechnology. And second one is modern biotechnology. Right? We are having two kinds. Traditional biotechnology and modern biotechnology. So traditional biotechnology, it is also called as ancient form of biotechnology or old biotechnology. or conventional biotechnology, all meanings are same. So in the question you may be heard, so conventional biotechnology or the old form and tartha, and this is the modern biotechnology. So here, say for example, suppose if you prepare the curd preparation, it is one biotechnology application. Curd preparation, milk get converted into curd. Who will convert? Microorganism, lactic acid bacteria. That means microbes are used. That is biotechnology. So my question is, whether curd preparation is a new technology or old technology? So that is old technology. That is coming under traditional biotechnology. Not only curd, fermented products. Most of the fermented products are coming under traditional biotechnology. Right? And preservation of the food. Say for example, if you are preserving any meat content, fish content, so that is coming under traditional biotechnology. Just I mentioned, sewage treatment plant, that is also coming under traditional biotechnology, old form. Suppose if we consider modern biotechnology, so modern biotechnology, sometimes we will briefly refer it as GE. So GE means here genetic engineering. Sometimes genetic engineering, we will say it as a modern type of biotechnology. Right? Now we are using that modern biotechnology. So you may ask the question, then what is the difference between these two? Say for example, now we are getting a corona vaccine, right? COVID vaccine. COVID vaccine is application in a modern biotechnology. Or in vitro fertilization embryo transfer, or DNA vaccines, or test tube baby, or gene therapy. So all these techniques are coming under modern biotechnology. So you may ask the question, what is the difference between these two, traditional biotechnology and modern biotechnology? Keep one thing in your mind. In traditional biotechnology, we are using organism, mostly microorganism. Mostly we are using microorganism, and those microorganisms are used as it is without changing their DNA or without changing their genetic material. Here we are not changing the genetic material of organism. As it is, we are using it. But in modern biotechnology, we are changing the chemistry of DNA. So here what we are doing? We are changing the chemistry of genetic material. So that genetic material is DNA. That means, already we know that we are related to the DNA. In the DNA, we are having the base pairs. So base pair sequence we are changing. So that is coming under modern biotechnology, right? And here we will not get our desired change. Change is occurring, but not according to our wish. But in modern biotechnology, we can change the organism according to our wish. Why? Because we are changing the chemistry of DNA. We can change the genes. We can change the characters. We can change the quality of product. We can change the quantity of product. So all are possible in modern biotechnology. And one more thing, this chapter majorly focuses on this modern form of biotechnology. Right? And one more thing, in another way, we can separate the biotechnology on the basis of these two terms. Product biotechnology, service biotechnology. In that way also we can define that way. Right? And just I mentioned here, modern form of biotechnology is coming in the form of genetic engineering. Right? And related to this biotechnology, EFB. So EFB means European Federation of Biotechnology. European Federation of Biotechnology. So it has given a proper definition for biotechnology. That means using of organism or using of cell or cell products to get any services or products which are helpful to human beings. So that is biotechnology. So that definition actually given by EFB. And here, if you consider this biotechnology, that means modern biotechnology, it is majorly working on two principles. So if you consider, the two principles of BT, right? And don't confuse it with this BT. This BT is different. What is that BT? Bacillus thuringiensis. That is a bacteria. That is not a this term. Here, capital B, capital T means biotechnology. So the principles of biotechnology we consider. The first principle is genetic engineering, and the second principle is bioprocess engineering. The first process is, or first principle is genetic engineering, and second one is bioprocess engineering. Genetic engineering, just I mentioned it simply here, genetic engineering. So keep on thinking in your mind. Engineering means already one form is there. We are changing that form. We are changing the form of what? Genes or DNA. Already DNA is there. So all organisms are having their DNA, and the DNA is having the particular sequence. Already that sequence is properly correct. And we are changing that sequence. So that is genetic engineering. So here, genetic engineering, it is simply nothing but changing the chemistry of a genetic material. How to change the chemistry of genetic material? Say for example, if we consider the DNA, right? Double-stranded DNA. Right? In this double-stranded DNA, we are having the base pairs. Right? Base pairs are there here. So we are having the sequence of base pair, and that sequence is proper, and that sequence is fixed. For every organism, that sequence is proper, fixed there is. Suppose if we change some of the base pairs, of course, from the mutation also sequence is changed. Suppose if it is a point mutation, one sequence is changed, point mutation. Suppose if it is a frame shift mutation, at the time, more than one base pairs are changing, whatever it is. By the mutation also, chemistry of DNA will change. But that is not by the mutation. But here, we are changing ourselves. Now we change what I here. That means, some of the base pairs we are removing, or some of the extra base pairs we are adding. So that is changing the chemistry of DNA. That is done in a genetic engineering. And you may ask the question, why? Why? Because, see here, suppose if we consider a bacteria, and in the same way if we consider a human being, right? Two organisms if we consider. In the human being, insulin will produce. Insulin helps in the control in the sugar level, right? That is the insulin hormone is there. For production of that insulin hormone, some genes are involved in the human beings. But in a diabetic patient body, those genes are not working. Now we need insulin from outer source. Now the outer source is the bacteria. Let me consider E. coli bacteria. Now what to do? Now the active insulin genes are inserted into this DNA of E. coli. Into the E. coli DNA we have to add. That means we have to cut the E. coli DNA and we have to add our insulin gene. Then E. coli start producing insulin. That insulin we can take. That means E. coli DNA chemistry we changed. That is called as genetic engineering. Or in the simple meaning, cutting and joining of genes, genetic engineering. Now, coming to this one here. Now, in the cell we have changed the genetic material. Now we have to grow that cell in a proper medium, optimum condition, in suitable environment. Why? Because we have to get the product. So for that one, we will use the second step, bioprocess engineering, or it is also called as chemical engineering. So both means are same, bioprocess engineering or chemical engineering. So these are the two principles on which biotechnology that is working. And here, one major thing. When organisms are showing the sexual reproduction, at that time also, the characters are changing. father is having one character, mother is having one character, after their mating, so the baby will be having another different character. That is also possibility is there. Why? Because due to variation. And how that variation occurred? Again the DNA of chemistry changed. And that is in case of sexual reproduction. In our sexual reproduction, it is not there. But in the genetic engineering also, we are changing the chemistry of DNA. But one difference, by the sexual reproduction, keep this thing in your mind, this sentence a little bit. By the sexual reproduction, of course the DNA will change, of course the characters are changed, but not according to our mission. Now, one could understand the character change. But by the genetic engineering, we can change the chemistry of DNA according to our wish, according to our need. We can change the characters, we can change the genes property. And because of that reason, we can get our desired product. So, namu bekar product varuttante. And here, this is genetic engineering. This is genetic engineering. So, we are talking about genetic engineering, right? So, this is genetic engineering. It is mainly having a technology. That technology is called as rDNA technology. What is the technology? rDNA technology. So here, R stands for recombinant. Recombinant DNA technology. You ask the question. DNA, okay, we know. What is that recombinant DNA? So recombinant DNA means two different DNAs are mixed together. Two different DNAs are mixed together, then we will get rDNA. So just I mentioned here, human genes. Gene means it's a piece of DNA. Human DNA mixed with E. coli DNA, then that is called as rDNA. So construction of rDNA, it is the major step in the genetic engineering. First major step is construction of rDNA. And along with that, so the next step is gene cloning. The next step, gene cloning. So what is the meaning of cloning? You may hear this term. So already you have heard this term, clone. Clones are the morphologically, genetically similar organisms group. Already we know that term, clone. So in case of asexual reproduction, we will get the clone. Clone simple meaning is Xerox copies. Xerox copies. Gene cloning means, already we have taken one gene, we need the product of that gene. Say for example, from this example, okay. Let me consider I gene. What is the work of that I gene? Insulin gene. Production of insulin hormone. Present in human beings. Not in bacteria. It is present in human beings. Insulin is ready for I gene. I understand that. Just. Now, I gene which is present in the human being transferred to the bacteria. But now bacteria are few in number, bacteria are less in number. Now those bacteria start to divide. So many bacteria are produced. When bacteria are dividing, inside the bacteria, our desired gene is present. What is our desired gene? Insulin gene. Now insulin gene also start multiplying, it start dividing. That means we introduce just one gene, and those genes are multiplied. Those genes are Xerox. That one we will call it as gene cloning. But to success that gene cloning, we need some methods. We need some conditions. Those conditions are achieved by the second step, bioprocess engineering. So bioprocess engineering, we are maintaining sterile condition. And these microorganisms are growing in a sterile environment. So sterile environment means unwanted microorganisms will not grow in that environment. So in that environment, our selected microorganisms are growing. At that time, gene cloning may be successful. But one more thing, for this gene cloning, we need different enzymes. We need a cloning material, cloning vector we need. So the normal discussion is the one. So this is one thing. And one more thing, gene transfer. Gene transfer. So Just I mentioned, from this part the gene should be transferred to another cell. Here, this organism different, this organism different. And one more thing, this gene, it is in the eukaryotic cell. This cell is prokaryotic cell. From eukaryotic DNA, the gene should be transferred to the prokaryotic cell. For transferring of that gene, again we need some vectors. We need some vehicle DNA, just like vehicle DNA vectors. With the help of vector, we can transfer the genes, gene transfer. Right? So all these steps are coming under genetic engineering. And you may ask the question, who is father of this genetic engineering? Who developed this technology? So actually, the genetic engineering, this branch father is Paul Burg. He is the pioneer of this branch, Paul Burg, father of genetic engineering. Right? Okay. So this genetic engineering, it is mainly having some tools. Tools of RDNA technology, right, to consider. Tools of RDNA technology. I hope you are getting what is the RDNA means. So RDNA technology means we are mixing two different DNAs. Why we have to mix? Why? Because we need one product, and that product produced from one particular gene. We are taking that gene, and that gene should be expressed, and that gene should be doubled. So for that reason, we are mixing this gene. This gene is our desired gene with another DNA. After mixing, we will get rDNA, right? For this rDNA technology, we need some tools. Okay, so you know the generalized thing. Generalized. So yadon cycle is there. ಸೈಕಲ್ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ನೀಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಸೈಕಲ್ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಬಟ್ ಸೈಕಲ್ ಪೆಡಲ್ ತುಳಿಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಪೆಡಲ್ ಗ್ರಿಪ್ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಪೆಡಲ್ ಸರಿ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಯಾವುದು ಸೈಕಲ್ ಇದೆ, ಬಟ್ ಆ ಸೈಕಲ್ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಓಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಬಟ್ ಅದ್ರ ಪೆಡಲ್ ನೀಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಏನ್ ಮಾಡೋದು? ಆ ಪೆಡಲ್ ಅನ್ನು ತಗೊಂಡು ಈ ಕಡೆ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಟೂ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಮಟೀರಿಯಲ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಜಾಯಿಂಡ್. ವೈ ವಿ ಜಾಯಿಂಡ್? ವೈ? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಒನ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್, ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು ನಾವಲ್ಲಿ. ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟ್. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ರೀಸನ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಡಿಎನ್ಎಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸಿಂಗ್. That is RDNA technology. For this RDNA technology, we need some tools. So if you consider those tools, we need enzymes. Major thing is, we need enzymes. And here the enzymes are, if you consider, I mentioned, REN enzyme we need. Restriction endonuclease enzyme. So regarding that enzyme, we can discuss further. First enzyme. Second one, we need lyase enzyme. Next one is lyase. So lyase enzymes means these are lytic enzymes, breaking enzymes, dissolving enzymes, digesting enzymes. And what is the work of these enzymes? These enzymes are digesting the cell to take out the DNA outside. If you want gene means, first we have to take the DNA outside. If you want to take the DNA outside means, first we have to break the cell. We have to dissolve all the materials. For that reason, we need these enzymes, lyases. So lyases means cellulase, pectinase, amylase, chitinase, all those are lyase enzymes, right? And then next one we need, ligase enzyme. Next one, ligase. Ligase means joining enzyme. Just I mentioned, I gene should be introduced into E. coli cell. Whether E. coli is having DNA? Yes, of course. Already E. coli is having DNA. But that DNA should be mixed with this gene. For joining, we need this enzyme. And this enzyme, it is also called as molecular stitcher. This enzyme also called as molecular stitcher. And this enzyme, it is also called as molecular sieve. Molecular sieve. It is a sieve and it is a stitcher. On the cut madodu holige aagudu. Right? Or this enzyme also called as molecular glue. Molecular glue ki that talking about. And next we need polymerase enzyme. DNA polymerase enzyme. If you are using the DNA, DNA polymerase enzyme. Right? So these are the different enzymes. Of course, apart from these enzymes, we need other enzyme also. Say for example, we need alkaline phosphatase enzyme. Alkaline phosphatase. So it is an extra enzyme actually. Alkaline phosphatase is a end modification enzyme. Suppose if it is the DNA is, DNA is having two ends, right? So these ends are modified. How actually ends are modified? So this alkaline phosphatase, actually it is removing phosphate group. It is removing phosphate group from 5' end. 5', 3', 3', 5'. From 5' end, phosphate groups are removed by this enzyme. If the phosphate groups are removed means, then to these ends, no nucleotides are joined, no base pairs are joined. So, avaga ee DNA work agudala time then. So, aa reethi modify mado enzyme kuda idalli. Right? So, okay. Anyhow, different enzymes we need. But these are the major enzymes. Except this one, these are the major enzymes. Then, second thing we need, cloning vector. Second thing we need, cloning vector. So vector means vehicle DNA, and cloning means doubling. Just I mentioned, cloning vector means the vector or the vehicle DNA which helps in doubling or multiplication of our desired gene DNA. That is cloning vector. And usually in cloning vector we are using different forms. So we may use plasmid as a cloning vector. We can use plasmid. What actually the plasmid is? So in the bacteria itself, in most of the bacteria, I mean some yeast. In most of the bacteria and some yeast, those are having plasmid. What actually the plasmid is? So plasmid is circular, double-stranded, extra chromosomal DNA. Circular, double-stranded, extra chromosomal, autonomously replicating. Autonomous, tanishtak tane replicate agudu. So such kind of DNA is plasmid. So that can be used as a cloning vector. So cloning vector simple meaning is, we have to introduce our desired DNA. We have to introduce our desired DNA into the host cell. Correct? That means we have to transfer our desired DNA or our desired gene into suitable cell. Suitable cell. For transferring, we need vector. Vector means vehicle. We need vehicle or vector. And one more thing, after transferring our desired gene into the host cell, that gene should be expressed. Ajin hange kutkoludilla. Ajin eno work madbeku olagade. Aa work madlikke help madabeku cloning vector. So we can use plasmid as the cloning vector, or we may use pagemid as the cloning vector. Pagemid. So page means already we know viruses. Viruses are called as page usually. Pagemid means it is a mixture of plasmid with that page. A page the DNA jothe idu mix maadi ready maadkondiruka artificial ready maadkondiruka. Or else we may use pages, just as usual, pages. So pages means bacteriophage. I'm saying about bacteriophage. So bacteriophage means the viruses which are attacking or eating the bacteria. ಈಗ ನಾನು ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ರಿಯ ಒಳಗಡೆ ನನ್ನ ಡಿಸೈರ್ಡ್ ಜೀನ್ ಹಾಕಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ರಿಗೆ ಯಾರು ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ನಾನು ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಂತ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಬಹುದು. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಬೈ ಆಲ್ಟರಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ವೈರಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್. ಸೊ ಪೇಜಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡಾ ಪೇಜಸ್ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡಾ ಪೇಜಸ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಕ್ಲೋನಿಂಗ್ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್, ರೈಟ್? ಬಟ್ ಒನ್ ಮೇಜರ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್, ಪೇಜಸ್ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಲೆಸ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾರಿ ದ ಡಿಸೈರ್ಡ್ ಜೀನ್. ನಮ್ಮ ಡಿಸೈರ್ಡ್ ಜೀನ್ ಅನ್ನ ಸೂಟೇಬಲ್ ಹೋಸ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕೋ ಟೈಮ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಪೇಜಸ್ಗಳು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಡಿ ಎನ್ ಪಿಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ತಗೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ದೇರ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಲೆಸ್. ಬಟ್ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮಿಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಮೋರ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಡಿಸೈರ್ಡ್ ಜೀನ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮಿಡ್. ಇಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಡಿಸೈರ್ಡ್ ಜೀನ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ಪೇಜಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ಆರ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್ we use BSE-YSE, bacterial artificial chromosome or yeast artificial chromosome. So those are also used as pruning vectors. But majorly in this chapter we are focusing on plasmid, right? Cloning vector. ಆಮೇಲೆ ನೋಡೋಣ ಅದು ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಏನಂತ. ಅಂಡ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಟೂ, ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟೂ ಎಂಜೈಮ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಲೋನಿಂಗ್ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೋಸ್ಟ್ ಸೆಲ್, ರೈಟ್? Host cell means the cell which is giving space, which is giving environment, which is giving suitable medium for what? For our desired gene. ನಾವು ಯಾವ ಜೀನ್ ಇಂದ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ತಗೊಳ್ತೇವೋ ಆ ಜೀನ್ ಅನ್ನ ಆ ಸೆಲ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಬೇಕು. ನೌ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಐ ಜೀನ್ ಇ ಕೊಲೈ ಇಸ್ ದ ಹೋಸ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಹೋಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇ ಕೊಲೈ, ಇಸ್ಸೆರಿಷಿಯಾ ಕೊಲೈ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಹೋಸ್ಟ್. So usually we will consider Escherichia coli as syndrome of biotechnology. Escherichia coli is syndrome of biotechnology, right? So that is used as the host cell. So host cell, that is the cell which is using our desired DNA in the rDNA form, and inside that cell that DNA should be expressed and should be multiplied. Host cell. And usually host cells are bacteria in most of the cases. And the next one we need, enzymes over, cloning vector over, host cell over. And the next one, bioreactor. What is the next one? Bioreactor. So bioreactor means these are the closed vessels, big closed vessels. So inside our host cells are present. What are present? Our host cell. What type of host? Transformed host cells are present. Keep that word. Transformed host cells are present in the bioreactor. What is the meaning of transformed host cell? The host cell, after receiving rDNA, the host cell after receiving rDNA becomes transformed. Those transformed cells are growing in one special container. That container is bioreactor, right? So again, in bioreactor we are having different types. Simple meaning, namma desired gene, namma ya product beko, aa gene anna modalu tagondu, aa gene anna host cell dalli haki, aa host cell anna ondu place nalli belisbeku adana. For growing those suitable host cell in particular medium, we need bioreactor, right? Yes. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಟು ಬಿ ದ ಮೇಜರ್ ಟೂಲ್ಸ್. ಇದನ್ನು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಟೂಲ್ಸ್ಗಳಿದಾವೆ, ಬಟ್ ಸದ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ನೋಡೋ ಮೇಜರ್ ಟೂಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಸೊ ಆನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿ ಎನ್ ಎ. ಸೊ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಇನ್ 1963, ಸೊ ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು ಈ ಆರ್ ಡಿ ಎನ್ ಎ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಎರಡು ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಡಿಎನ್ಎ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿಎನ್ಎ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕು. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕಟ್ ದ ಡಿಎನ್ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಜಾಯಿನ್ ದ ಡಿಎನ್ಎಸ್. ಟು ಕಟ್ ದ ಡಿಎನ್ಎ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದೀಸ್ ಎಂಜೈಮ್ಸ್, ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ವಿಚ್ ಎಂಜೈಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇ ಎನ್ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ಎಂಡೋನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೇಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದೋಸ್ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ಎಂಡೋನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯೇಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ 1963. ಸೊ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ವಾಟ್ ದಿ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್, three different scientists, they observed some enzymes in bacteria to avoid the growth of pages. He sent us the link code. Pages means viruses. Pages means the virus attacking bacteria. So some viruses are attacking to the bacteria, but bacteria did not allow the growth of the viruses. So a virus no bacteria attack maadidaga virus galu belilla bacteria olagade yake belilla anta scientist think maadidaga ee bacteria olagade kelavondishtu enzymes nu find out maadidaru. They observed few enzymes and the enzymes are restricting the growth of the viruses. So if it is a bacteria, if it is a virus, the virus is entering inside. How actually you are entering? The total virus cannot enter inside the bacteria. Only its genetic material enters inside. And when the genetic material enters inside, when the DNA enters inside the bacteria, that DNA will not work. So what we can say? The bacteria is restricting the growth of virus. Illiro bacteria, virus belilardange tadiyuttanta, restricting the growth. For that restricting growth, so enzymes are involved. Those enzymes are called as restriction nuclease. What are those enzymes? Restriction nuclease, right? And how actually those are inhibiting the growth? The first way, by adding methyl group to DNA. By adding methyl group to the DNA, for that viral DNA, some of the enzymes are adding a methyl group. So keep this in mind. Methyl group. For this DNA, if the methyl has been added, if the methyl group is added, that DNA part will not work. That DNA work agudilla already. Bandiro DNA work agudilla after adding methyl group. So that is one thing. And the second one, by cutting DNA. Second thing is by cutting, directly by cutting the DNA. That entire DNA will be cut. By these two works, by these two mechanisms, the enzymes are restricting the growth of viruses. What the scientists did? They isolated those enzymes. They took out those enzymes. Those enzymes are coming under the class of nuclease. What is the class of the enzyme? I will bar the class of the enzymes. Six class of enzymes are present. Oxidoreductases, transferases, lyases, ligases, so hydrolase are present, and the nucleases. Right? Different enzymes we are having, transferases. So in the class of nuclease, restriction endonuclease is one type. Restriction nuclease. In the restriction nuclease, again, we are having two types: restriction exonuclease, and second one is restriction endonuclease. Restriction exonuclease, restriction endonuclease. Both work is damaging the DNA. DNA work maadadu kadibeku. Eradu enzymes adhe work maadudu. Andre yaa rite work maadudu? By cutting, the second mechanism. These two enzymes are cutting the DNA. How actually those are cutting? Exonuclease are cutting the DNA from outside. That means they are removing the nucleotides from outside, not from inside. Endonuclease are cutting the DNA from inside, not just inside, at a particular place. DNA the particular sequence alli cut maadudu. And those enzymes are called as REN, restriction endonuclease enzyme. Right? And in that way, the first identified the restriction endonuclease enzyme is HIND2. This is the first restriction endonuclease enzyme, HIND2. Haemophilus, H stands for haemophilus, IN stands for influenza. Haemophilus influenza, this is the bacteria. Haemophilus influenza. D stands for strain of the enzyme. Sorry, strain of the bacteria. Strain of the thali and the bacteria. Thali galu. Haemophilus influenza D strain. In that bacteria, second isolated enzyme, second order. So here Roman letter means order of isolation. This is the first restriction endonuclease enzyme identified. First restriction endonuclease enzyme. Right? Okay. Related to the restriction endonuclease enzyme, one more enzyme we are having, actually major enzyme, ECO organ. So other jyothike, the tools galana. So detail agi nodthukolla. In the next class, let us observe the tools. And ondu innondu neevu iga swalpa hard work madbekante thoravagi nodta hogu. Majorly focus on NCERT. Right? Eshto questions na NCERT sentence as it is paste madirthare. ನೀವು ಎನ್ ಸಿ ಆರ್ ಟಿನ ಫೋಕಸ್ ಮಾಡಿರಿ ಕರೆಕ್ಟಾಗಿ ಲೈನ್ ಟು ಲೈನ್ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗಿ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ನಾನು ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಮಾಡಿರೋದು ಈಗ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ಎಂಡೋನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡೋಣ ಎಸ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು